Here we're asked to solve this using substitution. The first step in substitution is to isolate one of the variables. And it looks like I can get x by itself simply by adding y. So that's the easiest way to go. Let's do that. Here, if I did that, I'd have x equals y plus 3. Okay, that's if I added y to both sides. From that, I'm going to substitute x into the other equation. All right, so this is the substitution step. 2 times x minus y equals 12. Okay, we just figured what x was from this bottom equation. X is equal to y plus 3. Now, when you do that, the only variable left is y, and we can use regular algebra to solve for that. So 2y plus 6 minus y equals 12. And you have same side like terms. 2y minus y is y. Y plus 6 equals 12. Subtracting 6, y equals 6. Answers to systems always look like x comma y. And all we found so far was the y value. So then once you find that, what you have to do is back substitute. All right, when you back substitute in this case, you can plug y equal to 6 into any one of these original equations. But since we already solved for x, let's use this one. We know x equals y plus 3. And we just figured out what y is 6. Okay, so then x then is going to be equal to 9. When y is 6, x is 9. And then I can finish this off. 9 comma 6 is my answer. That's the point where the two lines cross. Now let's check real quick. Plug in the values. 2 times 9 is 18. 18 minus 6 certainly is 12, so that solves the first equation. Let's look at the second equation. 9 minus 6, well, that's 3. This certainly solves both of the equations at the same time.